Mr. Yi was not a politician. He was not a businessman. He was not a civil servant. And so he really had embodied within himself and in his own career, later on as a diplomat and then as president, I think his biggest contribution to Singapore was in making us understand the value of diversity, celebrating diversity, which he represented in his own life.
He cares about people, regardless of their station in life. You may be a clerk in the newspaper office, or you may be an editor, but he treated everyone with great courtesy and respect and care.
Every time he went to an event, he would walk around the room, always remembering who is who and what he did or what she did. And he will always mention something that made you feel that this is a man who respected and had given his time and had thought for people.
Mr. Wee was very at home in the UN. In the 3 months he spent with me, he made many friends and he impressed people by his warm, sincerity, intelligence, humility.
He's a very helpful person, especially with his friends, and he's extremely well-educated.
He had a dramatic life, you know. As you know, he grew up in poverty, left school at 14, went to work. He had very little formal education, but he, through self-education, through reading, through the university of life, I guess, you know, he became a very well-educated person.
As we thought when we decided on the naming of the center, we thought, would this be a name that he would be happy with? And he was very happy with it, to be associated with promoting cross-cultural understanding in Singapore.
We should not be an island where only students and academics live together, a little bit oblivious to what's happening around them in the society. We should be a very open university where many people from all kinds of backgrounds feel comfortable, feel there's no hurdle of getting into university, so that they can have access to some of the activities organized by the Wee Kim Wee Center.
The late President Wee Kim Wee was very wise when he advised us that a center such as the Wee Kim Wee Center needs to use whatever resources it can and whatever strategies it has at its disposal and can imagine to try and bring about not only greater awareness but also an in-depth knowledge of specific issues and challenges that face human beings.
So I think in that respect, the Wee Kim Wee Center will play a very important role in SMU in developing our own students, not just to be what we already are, articulate, having initiative, problem solving, but also very importantly, being sensitive to the differences that are within all of us.
I am grateful for having this platform with the Wee Kim Wee Center to not only address issues of concern for women in development, from the cognitive sense and the intellectual sense, but we also had the practical part of connecting and networking with different groups in the region, whether it is the NGOs, the businesses, and the government, so that together we can create the impact. On our own, we may not do a lot, we may not achieve a lot, but I feel that what we have done in the Wee Kim Wee Center has planted seeds in the region. We need to move from the academia to implementation and to realization. And that requires a lot more inputs from the community, from activists, advocates, people who have been there, done it, and the lessons we could learn. And I think that synergies of collectivizing experiences, research, information, and to bring advocacy to the forefront to create change, it's where I think the future direction for Wee Kim Wee Center.
Our immediate task, I think, for the future is to make sure that the Wee Kim Wee Center makes an imprint in the ASEAN region. And towards this end, we're going to work very, very hard to find partnerships and collaborations with some of the better organizations and universities in the region. And I'm very, very happy to say that work in progress seems to be proceeding very smoothly and the initial results are very, very positive.